guys, it's Heidi from Dreaming Color Creations. It's so wonderful to be back online again and be able to show you what I've got. Guys, at last, my latest African journaling kit and digital journal kit. The first package, the second one is slightly different to the first one. Although there's a lot of the fabrics from the first one that I'm using. There's also a brand new 46-page digital kit, as well as over 60 pieces of authentic African fabrics and mixed fabrics, which complements the African theme. I'm going to start right away. Okay, I'm first going to start with the fabric bundle, and I'm going to start at the top. Okay. First of all, with your kit, you're going to get, okay, this is just a small piece of it's almost like an upholstery fabric. I always put this one with because it's something different. It's almost woven, and yes, you can make a lot of stuff with it. Like a little tiny little belly band, or you can put it on top of a journaling card. Then here is your African fabrics. This is your, some of them are wax fabrics. You'll see at the back, you can almost see it. It almost looks like it's going right through. Okay, some of the fabrics, the wax fabrics are shiny and some of them are not. This is from the previous kit. Okay, all the sizes differ due to what I've had in stock, and also some of the patterns don't allow me to cut some of the pieces, you know, like in a certain size, where I've just basically cut out the images on the fabric. Okay, so here's the first one. As you can see, the colors of these are beautiful. With the second kit, I've decided I'm going to go with more brighter colors. You know, you don't always need to go earth colors. I mean, you can just combine them and it will just look beautiful. This one here is also another wax fabric, and you can see it's got silver in it. Most of these fabrics are also nice and stiff, so it's very nice to use as a decoupage medium. I've done, if you look on my YouTube channel, you'll see that I've done my African journal that I did for CJ. I actually did a collage of all the fabrics on the outside of my cover, and it turned out to be so lovely. Here's one which has got gold in it, and that is like a navy blue. Here we have another one, also with silver in it. I don't know if you can see the silver shininess. There we go. This here is almost a woven fabric. You can see all the little strips are sort of woven from side to side. There's two pieces of that. Okay, here's a African pot. Like I said, some of these fabrics are shiny, some of them are not, some of them are wax, some of them are not. But the colors are absolutely amazing. It's an African pot. Another African pot. This is from the previous collection. I've also put a couple of pieces of these in between. It's not an African fabric, but I think it really complements some of the colors that are in here, and it really looks stunning in a journal. How beautiful are those colors? This is like the sachet. It's the thin one. but it's also still very stiff, very nice to decoupage with. And even to work with your sewing machine, it's so easy. And they don't really fray a lot, which is also nice. Some more from the Sechue. I just love these African pots. I don't know if you guys know this, but this is a 3 feet, it's got 3 feet, these pots. We call it a poiki, and we make poiki course. Now that is basically, if I can put it, stew that we make in these pots on the fire, and it's absolutely divine. But it's also a traditional African pot. Orange one. Some of these will have cut offs that I've just put in extra or off cuts. Here's one of the shiny waxy ones. Look how lovely that is. And the colors are just amazing. It's super real wax, Mama Africa material or fabric. Here's another one, also shiny. I just love these colors. It's so beautiful. Here's another pot, but in a different color. Another shiny wax one. Now, I've cut these like this for a reason, because I think it will make a nice cover, and if I had to cut that little pot out, it would have ruined the whole picture. So I think you can really make something pretty out of it. When I saw this fabric, I was in love. Although it's not the wax one, excuse me. It's a much softer fabric, but it is really, it's got gorgeous, gorgeous colors. Now this is the original Sechue fabric. It's very thick, it's very stiff, doesn't fray at all, and the detail is absolutely stunning. Another one with the soft fabric. Look at those patterns and the colors, guys. It's just absolutely stunning. Here's a blue one, like the pink one you just saw. Each kit will also have one like this. This is from the previous collection as well. It's a very funny fabric. It's almost like a velvet, but not. It's a little bit more rough, and it sort of hooks when you pull it to the against the grain of the fabric. But it is lovely in leopard print. This is just my favorite. It's been my favorite from the first collection as well. Guys, is this not gorgeous? Look at those colors. It's all hand painted. And then obviously printed. But look at that. Isn't it absolutely stunning with the bling inside? It's a silver bling. Here's another one with some silver bling in it. Some more sashwe. This is green. This one has got gold bling in it, and it's also wax material or fabric. This has got a little bit of a shine to it. Some chiffon, like the larger leopard print. This fabric looks like it's almost scrunched up, and it's quite see-through, and it's very, very flexible, and it also doesn't fray a lot. And if you put that on top of that, you'll see it actually gives such a nice effect. Some more chiffon with the small leopard print. How beautiful is that, guys? And it's so soft. This is almost like a suede fabric, also from the previous kit, but it's so soft. I just love it. You'll be getting this net material or fabric, as well as the big one, the larger one, which the kit is, or the fabric kit is closed up in. It's almost like a nylon, but I'm really not a big, I don't really know my fabrics that well to tell you exactly what it's made of. You can see the leopard faces in it. Guys, like I said, there is so much here. This is just one of my favorite fabrics. All the animals, the wild animals on it. Then you'll also get this one, which is more abstract, but it is definitely African. There's your elephant, there's the lion. Like I said, each of them might differ slightly because there are not many options when cutting it. These will also slightly differ. There will be some of them that's got animals on, some of them who's just got the patterns on like this, or some of them has got the African ladies on them. Also from the previous collection. And then of course your larger knitting fabric. Okay, so that is that from the fabric bundle. Now let's see what else you've got in your kit. Of course, sorry, with your fabric bundle, you will also receive two cut-off leather cut-offs, pieces of leather cut-offs. Sizes will differ. They will be round about two pieces like that and two pieces of the other color. This is a dark brown. These are all genuine leather, guys. Maybe the tan. And then I also have the black and the red. Which is the red, is this one here. And your black. Okay. Now with your kit, you will also receive a couple of these porcupine quills. Guys, when you take them out of your packages, please, I am going to put a warning on the packets, and I'm also going to wrap them in bubble wrap, but they are quite sharp, and if they prick you, they do burn slightly, so try not to hurt yourself. Aren't they just absolutely gorgeous? Then each kit will also have two of these in them. These are my handmade cards. They will vary, either a lion and a rhino, or a lion and a leopard, or a rhino and a, a buffalo, depending on what goes in the kit. And they are all handmade by me. You will also receive a packet of these beads, where there's a little silver elephant in. Some other silver beads, some seed beads, little African beads, wooden beads, a huge variety, guys. And then that can be used for maybe a tassel on the back of your journal, or to be woven into the rope that you're going to close your journal with. Then you'll also receive a packet like this, which has got some raffia. It's got some four different color rope in it. That's gray and pink, almost like a salmon pink, brown and black, and then white as well. I think that's five. And then a piece of chain. If you don't know how to use the chain, go and have a look at my very first journal on my YouTube channel, where I used it to close up my journal on the sides. Then you will also receive a couple of paper napkins. Here I've got some leopard print. This is a safari one. You can see how gorgeous is that. And to decoupage with, I just love to decoupage paper napkins. It's absolutely stunning. Even on a glacine bag, it will look absolutely beautiful. Another leopard one. A zebra one. And another one. This one says Africa, but in Afrikaans. So you pronounce it Africa. It's got the K instead of the C. As you can see, it's gorgeous. It's the same basically both sides. Okay, now for the digital kit. Guys, I've really changed it a bit. I wanted to bring in more color, make it more interesting. I'm not a graphic designer, but I tried to manipulate a couple of pictures, some of my own artworks. You are also welcome to purchase the first digital kit. On, you know, it will be advertised, and you will see it on a link below on one of my videos on my channel. Okay, let's start quickly. There's a pencil sketch. Oops, wrong way around. Apologies. This is also from the previous kit. It's also one of mine. Also one of mine. These are my original artworks and paintings that I've sold and done over the years. This one as well. this one as well. This one here is also one of my favorites that I did. And it's actually, the original is in the USA, in New Jersey. Now you'll see I've put a lot of pages in. I did not put a lot of templates of corners and belly bands and pockets and so forth, because I just feel you can do so much more with a larger piece of paper that you've got the beautiful patterns on. Also one of my original works. How vibrant are these colors, guys? I mean, your creative juices just flow. You just want to start making, making, making. Another one. Almost like the previous one, but in a blue color. Sorry, I apologize. Diddy, come now there. Go. Come, Lee. Sorry, that's just my little dachshund, and she's really, really such a brat. She rules the household. So, there we go. Dexter, stop it. Dexter, stop it. I just love these patterns. It's absolutely beautiful, and the colors are so gorgeous. That blue-gray color is just my ultimate favorite color. There's some collages. These are all A4 paper, guys, so it's quite big. I love this one. Then I've done a couple of collages with some script all about Africa, which I got out of some articles and magazines, which I've just combined into this paper. Get it in the black, like a olivey green and a light brown. Then here's the zebra one, which was also manipulated. I just love this pattern. It is so gorgeous. Another nice one. Some African masks. Some peacock feathers. Pencil drawing. These are some vintage picks that I got. You can see there. That one's got the rhino, the ostrich, and that looks like, I don't know what you call it now. A lekkerwaan. I don't know what you call it, guys. I'm so sorry, but I'm sure you'll recognize it. Some beautiful maps with some of the wildlife in Africa. This one also has got a couple of wildlife images on. And then I put in a lot of images with quotes that you guys can put, make use of tags. Some South African postage stamps with the animals on them. These, I think, are vintage magazine posters or posters about Africa. There's also covers of old books about Africa. And this is just a script I thought that looked nice and might go with the old African theme. Then the beautiful photographs of all the beautiful animals you find here. Just quickly gonna page through them. It's the big five. That's an albino lion, and that's just a normal lion. That's the male, female. I got this picture off Pinterest. I just think it's really gorgeous. The king. I love this animal, the leopard. It's one of the most beautiful animals she gets, and also the cheetah, which is this one here. That's a hyena, and then here is tiny cheetah cubs. Aren't they just too gorgeous? Would love to touch them, but I don't think I will try. Okay, look at this baby rhino. Is it just not gorgeous? How beautiful. That is such a stunning animal. And to think that people want to make them extinct just because they have a myth about a horn. It's just so sad. There's some baboons. And that, I'm not sure what you call it in English, but in Afrikaans you call it a nag-aapie. And it's actually so tiny, it will fit into your hand. Actually, it's a little bit smaller than your hand. It's just so cute. Some more rhinos, baby rhino, wild pig, a pumba. That is a white rhino, who are basically extinct now. There's only a couple left in the world. Beautiful African tree, some rhinos. Some buffalo. Some bucks. Elephants and giraffe and some zebras, some more giraffe, and as well as some buffalo. Guys, that's the whole digital kit as well. Now for the big news. Okay, I'm just going to tell you a little bit something about this kit, and this is my second African journal kit, and it's authentic, it's unique, and the kit consists of over 60 pieces of authentic African and other fabrics which complement the African theme. Some of the fabrics are from my first kit. You will also get a variety of beads, ropes, raffia and chain, and two handmade cards, paper napkins, leather and porcupine quills. That you will all get with your kit. You will also receive the 47-page African digital kit, which is in PDF file, which as soon as I've received payment via PayPal, I will email to you with some of my personal artwork and stunning photos and African wildlife and lots more. Then the kit has more than enough fabrics and other goodies to complete at least two journals. The first and the second African digital kits are also available separately at $15 each. The kit or with the fabric bundles, paper napkins, the beads, the cards, the porcupine quills, as well as the digital kit will go for $100. That is including a shipment fee. Guys, my shipment is guaranteed, it is insured, and it will reach you within 7 days after you have paid. You know, if you need any further information about price, the fabrics, maybe any queries of some stuff you might want in the next kit, please let me know, and your comments will be very appreciated. There is only 30 of these kits available, so the stock is limited. Each African fabric and digital kit, you know, must be paid via PayPal, please. It's just a much easier way to do it. There's much more control. And then, yes, the good news. I will be doing a lucky draw. Once all 30 kits have been ordered, I will make a special draw, and one very lucky buyer will get their money back completely. So I will give you the package for free, and I will ship it for you at no charge. And then also, I'm also looking at doing another two draws, one for my subscribers, 300 subscriber giveaway, which I'm still a little bit far away. So guys, please go and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And then also 300 likes on my Facebook page, which is also Dreaming Color Creations. You will also see in the links below to the one to my African digital kit, the first one, my first African journal kit, and then also my African journal that I made. If you need any other information, or you would like to know something more about my personal work, please go and look on Facebook, on my Facebook page. And guys, yes, I would really... guys, my phone didn't allow me to do a bigger version than 4 gigs, so I'd just like to say, please subscribe to my channels, please go and like my Facebook page, and please like and share this video, and please subscribe. Have a blessed day, and thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye. Thank you.